Everybody, it's Invictad. It is time for our very first Eden run here in the Binding of Isaac Repentance. That is right. The Mosh Pit here on Twitch has voted, and they wanted to see an Eden run, so we're going to be doing an Eden run. You may notice the lack of a like streak counter or meme of the day, because obviously this is not part of the canonical streak or the Isaac series, but I wanted to record this one just to see how it goes. I don't know where we're going to be going. I'm sure the thumbnail probably shows you where we're going to be headed, but if it's going to be really good, we'll go to Dogma. If it's going to be kind of good, then we'll go to the Witness, aka Mother. So without further ado, let's see how our very first Eden run goes here in Repentance. Yeehaw. Book of Sizzle. Seed day is gonna be 6-4 November 7. Mike Tango X-ray 8. We got the Book of Sinvicta. Good start with here. Curse the Unknown, unfortunately, so we don't know how much HP we've got. Now, a couple of the things that I've been told about Eden is that you want to be trying to go for planetariums. Apparently, there are way more better astrological items. So, like the Venus, like we saw, like we talked about in yesterday's run or today, depending on when this video goes up on YouTube, is not the most exciting one that people have been talking about. They said like anytime Isaac faces one of the enemies, he charms them or something. But overall, Venus didn't seem like it was all that impactful. Apparently, there's like a lot of really, really good ones out there. So how do we get planetariums? Well, essentially, you just have to skip a couple item rooms and then that's that. So I think we'll probably skip like two or three just to see what we can get. And after that, we will evaluate. We will use this time to evaluate what we can actually achieve with planetarium run. So that means that we cannot go into the item room, I don't think. So we're not going to. I wish that the game actually showed you like a planetarium like counter or something. There we go. We got that. Okay, so we're going to buy the Soul Heart here, obviously, because we want to make sure that we cover our tracks. We don't know how much HP we have. We also have a Tinted Rock over here, which I'm just going to go do this. Another Soul Heart. Bueno. So we got pretty decent damage here to start off with. Our tears rate is a little bit low. We want to have at least two attacks or two shots per second. I still haven't gotten used to like to figure out like what's good in terms of like what's the base amount of stats that we want for like a starting run. Like in the old version of Isaac, now not in repentance. Obviously we wanted to have the we have the Swallow Penny too. I didn't realize that. Obviously we want to have somewhere like sub 10 tier delay and 3.5 damage, etc. But with Repentance, I have absolutely no clue. We have Soul Hearts, that's right. I have absolutely no clue what good starting stats are yet. We haven't gotten there that far, so. Maybe champion gurglings here. Boing. The troll bomb didn't hit them, excuse me? Gonna say boing. Okay, alrighty, had to get one of those in, didn't we, game? Range upgrade here. We could go down to Downpour. I don't think there's any reason to do so, unless if you want to actually have the extra, unless you want to have the extra item like pedestal. Apparently we have no red hearts either, so that's interesting. I wonder what happens if we use a strength card. This is just for science. I wonder if the Rotten Heart will stay with us because we use a strength card. Let's find out. Does not. Okay, so we started with 1 HP on this run. So that's pretty not great, I would say. And we can't reach those bombs either. Okay, so I was told, because I wasn't actually sure the first time that we saw the planetarium. I was told by Ed himself that the planetarium is a separate entity altogether from the item room. So it will not take the place of an item room if you spawned one. In other words, if you see an item room, you can still get a planetarium. They do not supersede each other. So that's good to know. That was good. That was good info by Ed. Okay, so I'm not going to open up that. I'm willing to skip two. I'm willing to skip two item rooms, and that's that. Because we're going to get run over pretty quickly here. And I believe that raises our chance to a 42% chance for a planetarium to spawn. If you're wondering why I did that, by the way, it's because I was looking for crawl spaces. It basically costs us nothing. Of course, we don't have any red hearts, so... Really? Another tinted rock here. I'm actually not going to use the bomb to get the chest, and we have a booster pack. I mean, you know, it's Pokemon cards, so you know. Unless, of course, we get 2 cents for one bomb. Thanks, game. You know what? Try that again. What I thought. Booster pack, collect them all. Got Joe free card, High Priestess. High Priestess is going to be pretty darn pog here. Because we will be able to use this against the boss. So essentially, the High Priestess gives us a free win here. Yeet! Yep, we get an Eternal Heart and an HP upgrade. I'm actually going to reject Stanley here. Okay. I'm glad I did not reject Stanley. Cambion Conception, I don't know what they've done to Cambion Conception. We could take Succubus as well, but I'm gonna go ahead and skedaddle with the HP. And I think we'll head on his own. I like our damage here. If we can get our HP up and get a good devil deal, we definitely have a chance against Dogma. I honestly think the path to Dogma is a lot easier than the path to the mother fight, but I believe that the Dogma fight is harder. So we need a lot of movement speed. Let's see if we get the planetarium here on this floor. You know what? We did not get a planetarium. So if we skip this item room on this floor, then that our chance becomes 63%. And I don't know if we want to be testing Sinvicta luck here with those kind of odds. I'm willing to skip one more time. But if we're going to fight Dogma, we're going to need a lot more than this. Another two bomb or two coin bomb, by the way. Low, 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 low. Now, of course, since we are doing Dogma, we can technically open up the item rooms on our way back. And we can still get them. We just have to get there first, obviously. But I think I'm gonna go grab Soul Heart here. We do have a strength card for a devil deal if we do get one. Our movement speed is not. I almost did a mad dash for it. And by a mad dash, I mean a very slow lisp. But decided against it. We got Frail. By gal. By gal? Obviously, Frail has not changed a whole lot in Repentance. Gotta be careful of the depth perception on the Ipecac shot. I have not seen Ipecac yet in the expansion. Ah! Thank you, asking it for me. Had a bomb, I would have used it right there, but I don't. Okay, we did get a double deal, and Passion Boy, hooray. We can get a Forget Me Now and do it all over again. Along with a quarter. But we would lose the Book of Sin. Now, I wonder if our planetarium chance has increased again, or if it's still currently at 60% right now. Or I mean 40% since it's Catacombs 1. It'll be at 43% right now. Something I should probably ask Ed. Alright, so we get a second chance here at getting a planetarium. Okay. That little schmoove with the flies, repentance. Little schmoove with the fly. You don't know what I mean by schmoove, by the way, because people in the YouTube comments are asking about that. A schmoove is basically when an enemy makes a little extra move when they shouldn't be. And they move in an erratic direction. Like that fly went diagonal for a second when it spawned just to make sure it was in range to hit us. That is a schmoove. No soul heart in here, unfortunately. We have a moving box. New expansion, new me. One makes you small. So we need to do a full clear here just to see if we got a planetarium. I doubt we did. Because that's just, you know, I mean, you know, it's your boy, Sin Victor Luck, coming at you live here. You know what? If you're going to schmoove, you're going to pay the price. You're going to schmoove on me, you're going to pay the price. Got to pay the piper. Now goes Lust. We get absolutely nothing for it. Temesis. A charge key with no space bar item. Yeehaw. See forever. All right. So no planetarium again. So now I'm assuming that our chance of spawning it is... I have no idea what this item is. Evil Charm. That sounds like a smart idea. Luck up and we feel protected. All right. Not sure what it does, but I guess we're going to find out. So I haven't seen the Super Secret Room either, which tells me... Oh, wait, no. We have seen it. Never mind. Go back. Go back, go back, go back, go back, go back. And our tears rate is definitely hurting here. Got about, I would say, an estimate of like 13 tier delay, which is how the French say le muy mal. So no planetarium here, unfortunately, and maybe we'll get one on the next flow. But right now, in terms of beating Dogma, it's going to be a little bit sketch. You know what, Keeper? You can have this. Courtesy of me. All right. All right. Here we go. This is the last time that we are skipping an item room, period, because we cannot afford to not take any more items. I wouldn't hit me if I were you. I wouldn't hit me if I were you. Wouldn't do it. Don't do it. Wretch is not going to be happy. Apparently, Widow also doesn't kill the spiders anymore when she leaps on them.
Actually, it's Invicta. It's not Widow. It's Wretched, okay?
No, it's a lobotomized Widow. Well, she's called Wretched. See? Deep lore. That's right. So I don't know what the evil charm does, but apparently it doesn't do anything. We get another HP upgrade and a fame. And Curse of the Lost. All right, we are done. We are done skipping item rooms. So we can now assume that our planetarium chance is probably 60%, maybe 80, question mark. Because technically we've skipped four item rooms now.
Judgment.
Okay, we get the dice shard, which is going to give us the D6 and D20. I'm not sure. I'm pretty sure that Athame no longer drops black hearts. Because black heart bombing is absolutely dead in Repentance, unfortunately. Faith card could be useful here. Bro, I appreciate all these, but like if you could just give me an item so I can be on my way, that'd be cool. Another HP upgrade here. I'm not going to use the dice shard on the HP upgrade just because we need the HP upgrade, but like you can get a planetarium, that'd be kind of nice. I'm just saying, kind of tired of not getting a planetarium now, you know. We did skip out like four item rooms now. Okay, all right, more schmoovin. Still trying to find out if we actually have a planetarium. Still haven't even found the item room on this floor, but we are not skipping anymore. I'm not convinced that skipping, so far anyway, my limited experience with planetariums, which is only one, I have not found planetarium items to be that worth it. But all my peers say apparently it is worth it. So we'll see. Here's our item room. Now, again, we could theoretically, we could just keep skipping item rooms all the way to Dogma, and then we can come back and get these item rooms. But the point is that we need to start getting items to keep us safe in order for us to get to Dogma in the first place. So I'm going to take the 10 bombs just because we may need them. Super Secret Room might be to the right of here, but with the way that with the new maps go, it's a new ball game. I think that is the only side of this map. For science, it doesn't look like Athame gives you any soul hearts at all. All right. Yeah, if Athame gives soul hearts, it's we're either getting super unlucky or just flat out doesn't do it. All right, no more testing Athame. I think that's pretty conclusive at that point. So still looking for the shop and or a planetarium. Our chance of getting one is at least 63 or 64%, something like that. It's at best 84%. We got a planetarium. Planetarium. Banana. All right. Let's see if it was worth it. We got a big tiers up and a size way down. All right. I mean, we did need the tiers up for sure. I think that we have now like the equivalent of like a 8-tier delay. Humbling bundle. I'm actually going to not take humbling bundle because I don't think it's worth it anymore.
Something's wrong.
I'd rather hold out for mapping or something like that. So we have a really, really, really small hitbox now. And we're going to move this very, very slowly over here. Mind Rage, yeah, I mean, having extended iframes, I hope is worth it. But hey, we got a planetarium, so we did get a universal item, astrological item, whatever you want to call it, a planetarium item. We definitely needed the tiers up, so now, to my understanding, the planetarium chance stays there for the rest of this run. So that's pretty darn good if you can spawn them, which we did. Thankfully. Now we need to get some more damage. Not sure where they're firing, but Emperor card. We will come back to get that. And hopefully we will get a devil deal here, although if we don't get a devil deal, I'll still reroll the boss item anyway. All right. At least we get a devil deal item here that we can reroll through. Oh, we dodged through that. Yeah, our hitbox is way smaller now. Okay, that's pretty darn cool. We get Maw of the freaking Void, and I mean, it doesn't give us any damage or black hearts or anything anymore, but it's still pretty darn useful. So we will go back and use the dice shard here to reroll that and cry that we wasted such a beautiful item, and we will head on down to the next floor. Maw of the Vizoid. I think it's lost its freaking status. Because unfortunately, it's no longer Pog. But it can still be useful in society today. All right, Curse of Darkness. Here we go. Now, we don't have to keep using Maw of the Void. In fact, we shouldn't use Maw of the Void because it's taking forever to charge. But it is still kind of nice having the range. It's just unfortunate that it cannot... it's unfortunate that it can't spawn Soul Hearts anymore. We may be playing that. I wonder if we can get another planetarium or if it's just one and done here. The soul converter. I'm not going to ding the donation machine. There's just no reason to. 73% now. Maybe playing that. All right, let's see what we can get out of this fortune telling machine here. Would not mind having crystal ball. We do have 3.5 luck, by the way, so... Oh, yeah. Wouldn't cross, I guess. Hold on to you. I mean, Blind Rage is... Blind Rage is actually going to be better than Wooden Cross here, I would say. There we go. See, that's what you need to be doing now. We need more of that. Yeah, there we go. All right. More soul hearts here. All right. So we spent all that money for 2 soul hearts, which is more than we would have been able to buy it for out of the store. But hey, at least we got something for it. Get a whole lot of bombs for 2 keys. We have 14 bombs, so I'm not really concerned about that. We've already found the super secret room, so it can't be to the right of that other one, the one that we were just in with the bombs and the 2 locks. Could use a bomb here to take some of these pills. Yeah, pills are good, right? Yeah. Yeah, there we go. See, no problem. Speed up. Absolutely need more speed up. That was the black and white pill. Got to remember that. No, Isaac, why? Because we can go back and use that hangman card to get that key if we really, really need it. Oh, the boy going to be dropping the fat beats on everybody. Steam sale, which, I mean, it's something. It's a little late in the game for Steam sale, but it might still prove to be useful. What's going on in here? My God, there's little pins. Oh, the D sizzle. Welcome. D-Sizzle in the house. All right, let's use this D-Sizzle to good use here. Oh, first you got to get past Reap Creep. The damage there, Maw. Had to get one hit on us. And 73%. Take screw. Which doesn't give us soul hearts anymore. We may... Let's see if we can... We should probably go get that key. I think what we'll do is we'll drop... Well, this could be a full charge here. We do have a full charge in the store. I'm actually going to go for the... Okay. Oh, a hermit card. Thank you. Thank you. Reroll the soul converter, maybe? Get mom's key. Okay. All right. All right. No. That ain't too bad. We're so small, we can barely pick up the item. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to drop the wooden cross inside of the item room. So we have another cracked key in there. Our tiers rate is starting to be pretty darn good. I think we've got like the equivalent of like a 6-tier delay right now. I'm looking forward to seeing what other items that we've skipped in those other item rooms. That we've skipped. You know, the ones that we skipped. Taking blind rage here. Might as well use a bomb on the fortune telling machine. And okay. All right. Now got 2 cents now. We can go into here and maybe get super lucky. All right. All right. So we have our Emperor card. Emperor card is going to be kind of useful down below. Because we don't have to go all the way to Blue Baby or Isaac. A couple bombs. We could get some more money here. We can go back and play that fortune telling machine. I mean, repentance forces you to kind of do these things. These old school strats where you would have to use arcade, you have to use the slot machines, have to use the fortune telling machine just to basically squeeze every resource you can out of any level. Make sure we didn't leave any fires in there. All right, one soul heart and I'll be happy.
Judgment.
All right. I don't know if with the new demon judgments, if we could have gotten extra taps of blind rage, we might have been able to. But either way, yeah, I mean, we can try for some black cards here. Oh, ho, 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 ho. We're running around the soul hearts. I mean, even one with one bomb is still worth it. And we will head on Dizown. We can still utilize the range of Maw the Void without having to hopefully put ourselves in harm's way that much. We still have a very good amount of shot speed here. Yep. And gonna utilize Maw the Void to hit behind and around rocks. We got to keep an eye out for the tinted rock as well, or the tinted skull, I should say, as well. Here we go. It's a small off. All right, so with a full charge here on the D-Sizzle, we're going to be looking for the item room. We do have a 100% chance to deal with the devil because we missed our 73%. But I don't think at this point we want to get rid of any of our HP, to be honest. Maybe we want to get rid of our red hearts, but that's about it. There we go. Looking for a tinted rock in here. I don't see any. There's a dice room, but I don't think I would re-roll this, so I'm not... Well, I guess with 12 keys, we can at least see what's in here. Yeah. And we're not going to be re-rolling this, although this is definitely worth the price of admission here. Wait for Maw the Void to charge up and go back in. Try to make our lives a little bit simpler every time we go into a new room. Hey, speed up. Another verp. We lost some of our tears up that we got from Pluto. And this will give us the ability to shed that. This gives us the ability to shed the HP that we didn't want. We get Diplopia. Interesting. This is Necropolis 2. Have not seen our Tinted Skull yet. We're still looking for the Fool card so we can get back out of the Mom fight after getting the Polaroid. This is not going to be a fun room with our stats, although the Mask of Infamy kind of ran into each other, made it a lot easier for us. Excuse me? Thank you. You're so small. Super tiny small. So we're going to use the Devil Deal. There's our Tinted Rock. We're going to use Diplopia on the Devil Deal, and if the Devil Deal doesn't have anything that we like, then we can use it on our item room and then roll it with the D6. And utilizing the range that we have here of Maw the Void, we stay relatively within the inside of the middle of the room. There we go. So we get the Polaroid. We did get a Devil Deal, obviously. We get Sulfur, Empty Vessel, and Guppy's Hairball. Sulfur is going to give us the temporary Brimstone, which we can use against the beast. Is it going to be better than... Will it be better than the D-Sizzle, I wonder? I think it might actually be better than the D6. Yeah, so we're gonna roll that. We're gonna use our charge on the D6 and roll that. We need to go back and grab that Emperor card as well. Go down to 3 cents here, so we can get the full charge. Yeah. course, that would require us having a full charge in the D6. I was just testing you. All right, acid baby, come on with it. Come on with it. We got acid baby, welcome to the party. Good to have you here. I'm gonna go back and I think I'm just gonna go with sulfur and we'll let it ride. We're gonna go back and we're gonna go get the emperor card. And now we're going to go into the mausoleum. I should say Gehenna. Gehenna deliverance. Don't remember where you were on this map. Here you are. Say goodbye to the Polaroid. Oh, we're not in Gehenna. We're in a mausoleum. I don't remember if there is a... Is there an item room on mausoleum? I feel like we should just use the we should use the Emperor card here. Ooh. So for people wondering, if apparently there's an old anti-birth bug where if you use sulfur twice in one room, it will give you permanent brimstone, but that has been fixed a long time ago. So there you go. To anyone wondering that in the comments. Yeah, there is an item room here, obviously. We could get a mystery gift here, and we might as well pop it in the item room, I think. Yeah. You know, range upgrade is going to be very, very nice from all the void as well as just our regular shots. And now I think we can just use the Emperor card.
The Emperor.
And away we go.
Just get over it.
You mean it's gone? How could you have spent our savings?
We're basically going to just save sulfur for the boss. What is that? Broken padlock. Bombs are key. Oh, that's right. I think that trinket just uses straight up bombs instead of keys. As long as you're holding it, I mean. So item room, we'll see what the blind item was. It was Taurus. I'm very glad I didn't take that. Unless Taurus, does Taurus give a move up, a movement speed up now? Do they change it to where it's not a movement speed down? Balls of steel. Thank you, acid baby. I don't know if they've changed Taurus for the better. Okay, it definitely does still give you the movement speed down. Good to know. For science. Movement speed slowly increasing. So it looks like it still performs in the same way, but of course we have a double tinted rock over here. We have our shield from empty vessel. Ooh. Oh, there goes all of our movement speed that we got. I definitely needed some damage here, so, and we got our tears rate back at least. It's spades, doubles our keys. Now that was just satisfying. So was that. We agreed. Daylight and a dollar short on that one. We should check our item rooms because we know that we skipped some more. I think we skipped some in the depths, maybe. Here's down. Yeah. I'd prefer not. And let's just say we did. I'd be very happy if we can end up getting a win here on Eden, especially a dogma win at that. Oh, they don't stop. Can't stop, won't stop. Yeah, so we did take that one there.
He's so destructive and disturbs just like his father. Look at who he has to look up to. If you're drunk, you get off.
I'm gonna go ahead and use sulfur here. There's Taurus activating. Definitely could use a tears up. Hematemesis does nothing for us, fortunately. I have a good feeling. This feels, I mean, we've got a fairly strong run here. I think that sulfur kind of puts it over the edge. I really don't want an HP upgrade at this point. I want to maintain our flying, but more importantly, maintain our shield from empty vessel. So we're going to go back and look for our item rooms here. I don't remember which item room we dropped one of the trinkets in. Once again, we go in the last place that we look. Ooh, luck upgrade. 4 luck now. There she be. All right, we got our cracked key. I think there might be another cracked key that we left as well. These cracked keys are used to unlock the tainted characters, as Ed calls them. And as you saw in the like streak goal on yesterday's episode, or today's episode, depending on when I put this one on YouTube, the new like streak goal for us is to do a all tainted week at 540 days in the like streak. So, and if this video also hits that, I will count this video as including the regular Isaac runs. These guys have so much HP. Gonna walk out, walk back in. Don't feel like dealing with that. No real reason for us to play a judgment right now. God, these things have so much HP, man. There we go. Tears up. We got it back. Thank you, Acid Baby. Coming up in the clutch, making the big time plays. What I like to see, son. What I like to see. Making the big time plays when we need it most. I don't think there's any reason. We've already got our crack key, so we're almost there. Now in Caves 1. We absolutely skipped an item room in Caves 1. Yeah, I'm gonna be waiting for the full charge on Maw the Void before we enter into the room. I'm gonna not take that soul heart, because we already have a full rack of hearts here. If we take hits, We'll come back and get that. Oh, tech one. I think we got to go tech here. Oh, baby. So we had tech one in one of our item rooms. And that is pretty darn awesome. Not a huge fan of the new tech sound effect, but it's still pretty. I like the new animation. That's got to count for something, right? Yeah, so we'll go back and grab that soul heart just so we can get back up to a full rack of HP now. We are looking pretty darn good. All right, down in the basement again. Because we're going through the basements, we're essentially going back up through the crawl space. And what this means is that we can go back and get those blind items that we left in lieu of a planetarium. So this is a strategy for those of you who wanted to take a little bit of a pointer from your boy Sinvicta. You can leave a blind item if you're doing a dogma run and come back and see which ones you missed. And we get the unicorn stump. That would have been nice, but unfortunately, I think sulfur is just going to be too useful here. Cheeky little shot right there. Now these guys actually have a ton of HP. Sir, I need you to calm down. Try to tell you. Slowly make our way through here. Yeah, no reason to take any sort of unsafe angles or anything like that. I'm still going to keep Blind Rage. I don't know if it's going to make a difference with us having the Polaroid Invincibility or not, or the Empty Vessel Shield. What in the world's going on in here? Hey, stop it. Up to basement one we go. And this is it. I don't think that Monstro's Lung is a good play here. That would have been fun for sure on the... if I had gotten Monstro's Lung on floor one, I probably would have gone after Mother instead. But I don't want to take the big tears down at this point, and I don't know how it interacts with Tech 1. Empty Vessel proc here, so we're just going to mow over this room. Cuban meat absolutely blocked all of those shots and then some. Wow. That's a big mulligan. There goes the plum. All right, here we go. And you know we gotta crank it up a little bit. You know we gotta crank it up because the tunes for this fight are incredible. There's the cracked door. This is where you use the cracked key. And there's Eden. We unlocked challenge number something. And we have the capricious. But we still have to win. What we've learned is that we have to win the run. We still have to win this run in order for us to get credit for it. Here we go, team. We're gonna hit you back. Maw the Void doing good work here. There we go. We actually got the empty vessel to proc as well. For some reason, Taurus is not proccing. I'm not sure why. And the vessel procking again. Perfect timing for this stupid phase. There we go. Down goes Dogma. Let's go! Let's see who the real beast is. The Maw. Double Brim. Mega Brim. The sulfur. Triple sulfur!
Smiting the mother of harlots asunder and setting the blood lake to a boil. As the beast descended down into the lake of fire, Isaac ascended towards the crack in the sky, and as he flew, he could see echoes of his past before him. He saw his mother mourning the loss of her son. He saw his father leaving them without turning to say goodbye. He saw his mother sleeping and his father taking money from her purse. He heard the late-night fights they had that kept him up at night, and the guilt he felt for what he believed he was causing. He felt the pain in his stomach during those sleepless nights, and saw his shadow in the closet waiting for him. As he rose, he felt his fears drop from his body, his shame, his worry, pulled from his being. As he became lighter, his ascent became faster. He saw his one true companion alive and well. He saw his mother and father together again, holding each other. He felt his mother kissing him on the head after he had said his prayers, and the comfort in knowing someone was watching over him. He saw his own birth, and the faces of his parents filled with joy and optimism. And then he saw nothing.
Are you sure this is how you want this story to end, Isaac? You're the one writing it. It doesn't have to end this way. Here, how about we tell it a different way? Maybe a happy ending?
Okay, Daddy.
Good. Are you getting sleepy yet?
Yeah.
Okay, so, Isaac and his parents lived in a small house on the top of...